Hey, it's Don Skaggs with Empowered Inventing, the one place where we try to help you help other people by taking your innovation, opportunity, and some sound wisdom and trying to turn those things into real products, like or real businesses. Today I want to talk to you, I want to ask you a question. Are you a finisher? Are you a finisher entrepreneur? Are you a finisher inventor? Or are you one of those people that just have a lot of ideas or a lot of half-finished products all laying around and you don't know why you've got all of these things but nothing that's brought to fruition? Well, I want to talk to you a little bit about that. Because a lot of us, we're all guilty of this to a certain extent, but I've seen a lot of inventors that just kind of take this to a whole nother level, where they've got so many ideas, and all of us as creative people, as inventors and entrepreneurs, we all have really great ideas for businesses, great ideas for products. And the danger is that we have all these ideas. You know, we've got three before breakfast, we've got four that we came up with in the shower, and we, you know, by noon we're just bubbling up sometimes with just ideas, and we're sometimes just furiously writing them all down. I would suggest having some type of idea file where you're just keeping all of these things in one place and going through them periodically. But that aside, because we all have that, we all do that, the danger is with a lot of inventors and entrepreneurs out there, you will have this tendency to start a project and you'll get so far into it and then it'll start to get a little boring, or it'll start to get hard. It'll start to get a little difficult, or you'll hit some step that is just feels like a roadblock. And then about that same time, you'll see something over here that's all shiny. It's a new idea. Oh, wow, this looks a lot easier than this thing I've been working on. I tell you what, I'm just going to set this aside, and I'm going to go over here and start on this other one. And then you get into that other one, and then all of a sudden it becomes the difficult one. And then you're like, oh, gosh, this one's difficult to, oh look, here's another one that's shiny. Let me go over here. So you're always chasing something shiny. You're always going after the new thing. And the problem with that, even as great as so many ideas we have as they are, the problem we have is that we end up with all of these projects. So I want you to look where you are with your current invention, with your current startup, with your current business idea. And I want you to ask yourself how long you've been there on that one step, whatever step you're on. And you know, we have idea steps, you know, all of these steps that you take to get from original idea concept to an actual product or business where you're attempting to make money with it, attempting to have ROI, return on your investment. So ask yourself in that process, where are you stuck? Where are you and how long have you been there? Have you been prototyping and you're just still prototyping? Have you been researching your patent and or your IP? Have you been doing marketing prep? And whatever step that you're on, how long have you been there? And why? And if it's been a long time, why are you stuck? And what's holding you back from the next one? So ask yourself that. Now the other thing I want you to keep in mind is to realize, do you then move away from that idea and onto something new? Is that kind of your modus operandi? Is that what you end up doing most of the time? Or do you feel tempted to do that? Well, I think we all sort of feel tempted. When things get hard, we look for, oh, look, this is easier. Let me go do this. So we're tempted to do it, but do you end up doing that? So, and a hint of that, again, is having a lot of unfinished projects, a lot of unfinished startups, a lot of unfinished invention prototypes, whatever, just sitting around gathering dust. And if you end up with a lot of those, and they're all half-finished projects, and they're all gathering dust, and you're off to the newest of the new thing, the new novel thing, then that's a really strong indication that you are not a finisher. You're not finishing, seeing something to fruition. So, how do you break free from the cycle? Well, one thing is that you have to make a decision. If you are stuck in a certain place, you have to kind of come to terms and understand why you are stuck in a certain place. Are you stuck because it's insurmountable odds against you. Did you find out you just didn't have a market for this thing? Nobody really wanted to buy it at all, ever? Did you find out the market was too small? Did you find out you couldn't make it? It wasn't manufacturable? You know, there's a lot of different things that could make you stuck, but a lot of times we're so enamored, we're so sometimes in love with our invention. You know, we gave birth to it, we're treating it like a baby sometimes. Don't do that, by the way. But we're so enamored with our idea that we don't want to face that, okay, this is not going to work. And if you come to terms with that, what you're going to have to do, and it's sometimes the hardest thing for inventors and entrepreneurs to do, you're going to have to take it out in the backyard, you're going to have to dig a hole, you're going to have to bury the thing, say some very kind words over top of it, and then walk away. And that's when you do move to on to something else. But have a finality of it. Don't just kind of leave it around. Just let it be some kind of a zombie idea that's a half-finished project. I want to get back to that someday. No. You be done with it. If you have a good reason why you need to be done with it, you need to come to terms with that and be done with it and then move on. And again, we all have a lot of ideas, and maybe it will lead you to a better idea. I've had that happen a lot. I've seen a lot of inventors that's happened to as well. So, make the decision to walk away if you need to. If not, if it's something that you could, I'm just kind of stuck. Then what you have to have is a plan. And if you don't have a plan, the great old saying is, if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. And it's so true. You have to have a plan. And that plan has to have, that can't be some nebulous, yeah, I'm going to do this and it's going to be successful someday. That's my plan. Or here's step one, here's step two, step three, a miracle will happen. And then step four, everybody's rich. No, that's not a plan either. A real plan has real milestones with deadlines. And I know sometimes you don't make a deadline. That's okay. As long as you set a deadline, and if you miss that deadline, you go back and you examine, okay, why did I miss this deadline, and what can I do to make the next deadline I need to set for this? And don't have it be constantly moving either. Again, this is not a 10-year process. This isn't a 5-year process. This is a short iteration of finding out, is this going to work or is this not going to work? And again, you have to go bury it out in the backyard and move on, or you plow through and you say, okay, this does have potential. I am going to do this and I'm going to see it all the way through. So make a plan, walk away if you need to. If you find out that's not the, it does have wheels on it, then you want to move forward. You want to have a plan with milestones and deadlines, and then use your superpower. You have a superpower. If you're a creative person, you're an inventor, you're an entrepreneur, you have this superpower, and it's your creativity. You wouldn't be coming up with all of these great ideas if you did not have that superpower. Now, the thing is the most inventors and entrepreneurs, they take their creativity, they come up with their idea with it, and then they leave the creativity at the door, and they just move on, and they don't use that creativity through the rest of the process. When you hit a roadblock, when you hit something that's just kind of just stopped you in your tracks, and you're saying, how do I get to this next step? How do I get to this next part? And it then take that creativity and find a way around it. And you know, sometimes that's where the best innovations come from, is when you hit a problem that you just think can't be solved, and you take that superpower of yours, your creativity, and you use it to get around that problem, just like you did to come up with the idea. You come up with ideas to get around that problem, then that might leapfrog you into being far ahead of anybody else with a product, a business, or a business niche. So that can be so powerful for inventors and entrepreneurs, and is so underutilized with so many people. So keep that in mind as well. And lastly, get help if you need it. Get help when you need it. There's not going to be an if about it. It's a when. And again, as I've said before, there are lots of really good inventor groups. InventLeaders.org is the IGA and Inventor Groups of America, which we have our organization involved with, the Inventors Network Kentucky. But not just in Kentucky here, but across the country, there are groups like ours. So find your local group. If you can't find a local group close, find one that has online meetings. We have online meetings at kyinventors.org, by the way. So just a little plug for that. But get help when you need it, and get help from real inventors. Don't call some number you saw an ad for and somebody's just wanting to take your money. So or some top of a website search that came up and you're just answering an ad. Don't do that. Find real inventors who are facing real problems, who are overcoming those real challenges, and get with them and find out how they did it. The real people. So, and of course, we can help you too in poweredinventing.com. We've got, our mantra is learn, plan, and do. You can learn things. We do coaching and consulting, so we can help you to make your plan, and then we try to connect you to the right people. So anyway, with that, I'm Don Skaggs, and this is Empowered Inventing TV. And I will look to see you at the next meeting, workshop, class, or on the next video.